feel to have such a loyal fan base after
25
years?
I think the fans that we have had over the last several decades, you know, there is nothing quite like that. And I think we have a massive debt of gratitude to them because they've really stuck through a lot of craziness. I mean, we started a record company on our own 15 years ago, and they're still here. You know, we went through, you go through a lot of ups and downs in life and so on. They're still there, you know, and I think one of the things for us, I think that we've always felt is, you know, you have to work hard at giving your best to people as often as possible, because you never know. You may only meet this person one time ever. Right. You better make sure that you give your best that day, that moment, as much as possible. And so maybe it's a little bit of a reciprocal relationship. Maybe they really feel that we do truly care, because we do. And that's maybe why you're able to, you know, stick through a lot of craziness along the way.
When somebody walks up to you and they say they've been to 20 shows or 100 shows, or they've bought every album or whatever that is, right? They show you their tattoo.
Then
here's
Taylor
my Hanson tattoo. Yeah.
You know. Yeah. Zach, you weren't supposed to out me on that.
Yeah, well. there's really no greater encouragement for what you've done and sort of push to continue to, like, keep going, keep doing that. Don't stop. Don't second guess. Just stay the course.
Touring has definitely changed over the years for you all. Obviously a lot more kids now. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How has that been for you? How has tour changed?
Well, I mean, we were kids and now we have kids.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we basically haven't changed the rider since.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, a revolver. There's more beer on the rider,
some of which we make.
The thing that's cool about our lifestyle is we really have, you know, traveled and toured, you know, and worked since we were kids, and so we've had so much time kind of in this field. There's such a familiarity when you're out on the road. I think the main difference really is just that there's sort of even more of a posse, you know, as we've all had families. Like, there's more of a, I mean, the party has just sort of grown.
Every musician needs kids because, one, it's an insane, incredible inspiration. Yeah. But there's no better medicine to keep you from becoming a bad stereotype of a, you know, pop star or a rock star than your kids, because they don't look at the world and worry about dad, right? You go, hey, I'm flying to Japan tomorrow. I'll be back in a month. You go, so you're gonna miss my soccer game, right? And they go, are you bringing me back a toy? Hey, yeah. It's like, okay, see you in a month. Like, they look at the world through what they're doing and what they're excited about and where they want to be. And obviously, they love you and they, you know, cherish you being around. But it gives you, I think, an amazing perspective on this idea of, like, being in the moment, and also this idea of you not being the most important thing in the world, right? There's somebody who loves you and wants to be around you. But when you say you're flying to Australia, they go, oh, that sucks, because I was gonna go to this thing and I wanted you to come to it. Like, it's not, they don't wanna go with you, they want you to do whatever they're doing. And I think it's a great, it flips the whole world on its head, where you're used to standing on stage and the adoration of the crowd and the screaming girls and, you know, the crew that will, you know, oh, I want this thing, and they run out to the store and they bring it to you, like that stereotype of artists getting whatever they want. And kids just aren't that way. They expect
just
you to be the crew.
Remind you that you're supposed to be their biggest fan.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Taylor, you're having your sixth child?
Yes, I know, I'm showing.
December?
Yes.
Wow. Is this, you've always dreamed of having a big family?
No, actually, I would have never said I dreamed of having a big family, but as a kid, I always was really passionate about whatever I was doing. So when you meet the right person and you start having kids, you love them and they're, you know, you enjoy having a family. And so we've just really said, well, we like having one, like having two, like having three, like having four. And so the more we've had, the more it's been a blessing. So I think we're really excited. I mean, one at a time.